Hello children, good morning and welcome back to your science class. In the last class we have discussed about the chemistry of acid, their uses, their type. Today we will try to learn about the harmful effect of acid to our environment. Regarding this we have to study about acid rain. So let's come and see what is acid rain. Here we have to know that how the rain becomes acidic. What happens, dear children, whatever the gases, the harmful gases released from the factories, the chimneys of the factories, like sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide, nitrogen dioxide, when these gases mixes with rain or water, it comes back to our earth in the form of acidic rain. So generally to make acidic rain, the harmful gases like sulfur dioxide, you can see that sulfur dioxide, this is your harmful gases releasing out from the chimneys. You can see carbon dioxide, or you can see sulfur trioxide. When these gases mix with rainwater, that is water, so you can see such type of reaction took place. The first one form sulfurous acid. After mixing of carbon dioxide with water, it will form carbonic acid. After reaction of sulfur trioxide with water, it forms sulfuric acid. So this way, the whatever the gases which are formed by this combination of the gases along with rainwater, the rainwater becomes acidic, and when such rainwater falls on our earth or the land, it creating enough different type of harmful effects. So let's come and see the harmful effect of acid rain. So what are the harmful effect of acid rain? See, acid rain, as the rain contain enough amount of acid, so when such type of rain falls on any field, or you can say any agricultural field, this makes the field acidic, and it is very tough to grow crops in acidic field. So first dangerous effect of this acid rain to damage the fertility of the crop field. Clear? This acid rain is that much effective that when it falls on our skin, it creates irritation. It may sometime it may damage to the leaf or any part of the plant. Actually, this acid rain is that much effective that when it falls on any aquatic bodies, it also creates problem for aquatic life. So this acid rain is very dangerous, and we should try to do some preventive measures so that we can minimize the effect of acid rain. Clear? So dear children, how can we minimize, how can we prevent the acid rain? So that is very important to know that the preventive measures against acid rain. See, already I have explained to you right now that acid rain is because of harmful gases released out from the factories or from the exhaust of automobile. So to prevent the acid rain, first important thing is that we should minimize the use of chemicals. We should try to minimize the use of fossil fuel like coal, petroleum. So if we minimize such type of thing, definitely the release of such type of gases like sulfur trioxide, nitrogen dioxide gas will be minimized, and definitely it will minimize the production of acid rain. Not only that, we can also promote car pooling, bus pooling. So in this way, we can minimize the production of harmful gases. So we should try to prevent the acid rain, otherwise it will be problem for mankind, for all of us, and also for the plants. So dear children, we should try to minimize the harmful effect of acid rain. If we are very much careful, easily we can minimize the effect of, minimize the production of acid rain. Clear? So this is the harmful effect of acid on our environment. Now let's come and see the chemistry of another chemical substance, that is base. Clear? So basis, we have to study after that chemistry of basis. first of all, let me clear you what do you mean by bases. Actually, bases are certain chemical substances which are slippery to touch, soapy to touch. Means when you touch, it will just like soap. It will slip between your finger. When you keep the bases in between your finger, it will slip. There are certain chemicals are there where the bases are present, like baking soda, like soap, like toothpaste. Maximum cleaning agent base are present. Clear? So bases are very important, and actually when you test bases has already I have explained, but you have to know that bases are, they are having the beta test, the general properties, you can say beta test. If you want to know the properties, these all are the properties of bases. Clear? Bitter test, soapy touch, when the bases react with AC, there will be formation of salt and water. So bases form salt and water with AC. Clear? This is also called, you can say this is called neutralization reaction. This reaction, you can say that it has a neutralization reaction. So bases are very important in this response, that bases we are using in some certain chemicals, or you can say the cleaning agent. So actually we can classify the bases as a strong base or weak base. So based on that, bases are also corrosive, means dangerous. We can write in this way, bases are also very corrosive, or you can say dangerous, harmful. Some bases, dear children, here I want to mention you that some bases are water soluble. Not all bases are water soluble. Some bases, when you dissolve the bases in water, they are easily soluble in water. And such bases which are soluble in water, they are regarded as alkalis. Clear? So, you can write another property. Water soluble bases. Water soluble bases are called alkalis. Clear? But here I want to mention you that all the bases are not water soluble bases. That's why all the bases, we cannot consider all the bases as alkalis. Clear? But alkalis are those bases that are soluble in water. So we, for this we can write that all alkalis are bases, but all bases are not alkalis. It means that dear children, only those bases which are soluble in water, that bases, or you can say that category of the bases, are regarded as alkali. But all bases, or you can say those bases which are not soluble in water, we cannot consider that those bases as a alkali. So for water soluble, quality should be there for any base to be alkali. Clear? Now we can also classify the bases as a strong base or weak base. Clear? So bases can be classified in this way. Bases we can classify as a strong base and weak base. Here I want to mention you that bases, both type of base are soapy to touch, bitter test. But we cannot test all the bases. Maybe some bases are dangerous. So based on that, some are corrosive in nature. So bases can be classified as a strong base or weak base. A strong in this sense that they are very harmful. Clear? Very dangerous. So many bases are, they are very corrosive. Example, you can write sodium hydroxide. Formula I am writing here. Also writing the name of this. Here I am first writing the name and formula. First is sodium hydroxide, very strong base. Second is formula is, and we have, dear children, you have to know the formula also, NaOH. Second is potassium हाइड्रोक्साइड KOH पोटेशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. हेयर ऑल्सो आई वॉन्ट टू मेंशन यू दैट दीज टू बेसिस दैट आई हैव रिटन हेयर दैट आर स्ट्रॉन्ग बेसिस दे आर वाटर सोलेबल ऑल्सो. सो means if they are water soluble, as I have explained right now, that if they are water soluble, they are alkalis also. So sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, they are bases as well as alkalis. Why they are alkalis? Because they are soluble in water. That's why these two, maybe you can take the example of these two bases as a alkali, sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide. But what about the weak base? Actually, weak base are those bases that are harmful, but that are not that much harmful than as a strong bases. So many examples are there of this weak bases also. You can take iron. Here I am writing first name. Iron, hydroxide. You can take zinc. Hydroxide, example, these all are the example, formula I am writing, FeOH whole 3. Dear children, you try to learn the formula also. Zinc hydroxide formula is ZnOH whole 2. So this way we have seen that bases are classified based on their nature. We can classify the bases as a strong base, means they are highly corrosive, weak base, less corrosive. Examples are like this. Sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, there's so many other examples, calcium hydroxide, they are strong bases and they are very strong in this sense. They are dissolved in water. The sodium and hydroxide and potassium hydroxide are dissolved in water, and if they are dissolved in water, definitely they are bases as well as alkalis. But there are certain bases, like you can see that aluminium hydroxide, this is a base only and it is not going to dissolve in water. Clear? So it is not dissolved in water, it is not a water soluble base, so it is only a base but not alkali. Clear? And we can also see the bases as a weak base. These all are the example, iron hydroxide, zinc hydroxide, these are also harmful base, but not that much when we compare with a strong base. Clear? So dear children, you have to know the basic properties of the bases, different type of bases based on strong and weak base, and alkalis related concept you have to clear. So here I want to mention a very important question, dear children, that sometimes we are asking that all alkalis are bases but all bases are not alkalis. Here you have to explain that only water soluble bases, those capacity of bases who are soluble in water, these bases can be considered as alkali. Clear? But all the bases are not water soluble, so those bases which are not water soluble, we cannot consider such bases as an alkali. Clear? Understood? Okay children, let's come and see the everyday use of some basic bases. These all are the general bases that we are using in our daily life. One by one we are just going to explain the basic usage of these bases. First is calcium hydroxide, that is also called slag lime. Another name of this slag lime is lime water. Lime water generally we are using to whitewash our wall of houses. Clear? Lime water also we can use to neutralize the acidity of the soil. Generally during the acidic rain, when the soil become highly acidic, that is not fit for the growth and development of our crop, to make neutralize of our soil, we are adding this slag lime or lime water so that the neutralization reaction take place and that will neutralize the effect of acid in the soil and make the soil fit for growth and development of crop. Next you can see sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide, this is also a strong base. Clear? This sodium hydroxide is used in making soap, detergents. Clear? And this is very important base. It is also used as alkali, means it is water soluble base. Next you can see it is the ammonium hydroxide, that is a weak base. This ammonium hydroxide is used as a cleaning agent, as a household cleaner, and also it is used in making fertilizer. Next you can see potassium hydroxide, that is also called caustic potash. It is one of the important base used to make biodiesel. Clear? And it's also, you can see, it is a strong base. Now you can see the last base that we I'm going to explain, that is MgOH2, that is also called milk of magnesia. Actually, it is very important base. Reason, there is a reason that when we have acidity in our stomach, then generally we are taking milk of magnesia, because it has wonderful property of anti-acid. It neutralizes the effect of acid. Clear? And that is the reason we are using this milk of magnesia. So these all are the important bases whose everyday uses we have discussed right now. Not only these bases, there are certain bases also there that we are using everyday. Clear? Now dear children, let's come and study that how these bases we can make. So regarding the preparation of bases, we can make, generally making the bases by oxide of metal. Clear? So regarding preparation of bases, then we are just first making metal oxide, and then this metal oxide, when we will dissolve in water, will get base. For example, suppose sodium, when it is allowed to react with oxygen, there will be formation of sodium oxide. And this sodium oxide, when you allow to react with water, there will be formation of a strong base, sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen gas. This is the when metal react with oxygen, metal oxide formation, sodium oxide formation is there, and then when you add with water, it will change into base, sodium hydroxide. When you use the formula, because formula is very important, this is the symbol of sodium, Na, oxygen symbol is this. Sodium oxide we can write Na2O, and this, when it will allow to react with water, there will be formation of sodium hydroxide, a very strong base, and release of hydrogen gas. So this is the through formula we can also explain. Okay, dear children, today what we have explained, uses of different bases, properties, and certain this preparation. So if you have still any doubt, you all are free to ask, try to learn, try to revise the previous topic, and try to understand the concept. Thank you, and have a nice day to all of you.